Well, they've been described as the new flight of the Concords, having found success after videos they posted online went viral. In a moment, we'll speak to one half of the Bondi Hipsters. But first, let's take a look at how they came together.
For Nick, it was Trent from Punchy, followed by the whale who was beached as.
Oh, shit! You're beached is! Tell me something I don't know.
Christian Van Vuuren becoming a viral sensation came naturally when he was fully sick with tuberculosis.
Well, now, my friends, I'm back again, and I'm fully sick.
Nowadays, Christian and Nick have teamed up and are living a gluten-free lifestyle fed mostly on goji berries, riding their fixies by the sea.
And sometimes we change the sound of words A, like instead of rage, we say Rajay.
Between the two of them, they're verging on 14 million YouTube hits.
All right, Christian Van Vuuren is one half of the Bondi Hipsters. Thanks for coming in tonight.
No worries. Well, I'm here on behalf of Dom and Adrian.
Right,
you
I
know,
see.
Channel 10's way too mainstream for either of them to want to come in and visit.
Okay.
So I think
it's
they only appear live on Al Jazeera.
Right, yeah, something way off centre. Yeah.
Yeah.
Have you been kind of blown away at how big this has become? Because, I mean, it is a worldwide hit, I think.
Look, it's really exciting and it's fun, but I think... we're not particularly blown away by this thing. Like, since Nick has had success virally in the past,
yeah,
and we've done stuff virally in the past, we had a bit more of a plan with Bondi Hipsters.
Right. So there's method to this.
There's method to this one.
What is the secret to viral success?
Well, I don't think there's really a secret to what will guarantee that something will get a lot of hits online, but I mean, when I say there's method, like, it's not like there's a big strategy, it's just let's post a video once a week.
You do both come from marketing backgrounds, don't you?
Yeah, yeah, right. So we've both worked within media and marketing.
Christian, you're hip and you probably worked out I'm not.
I wouldn't sell yourself short.
No. I'm pretty on the money here with this. I just want to know, like, because you know hip, are red jeans hip?
Red jeans, yeah, they're totes hip.
Totes hip?
Yeah,
yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Totes
hip.
Yeah.
So where to for the hipsters? I mean, are they? I am assuming you're kind of being approached by big international media companies wanting to do something bigger with it.
We've been lucky enough that some studios and networks from around the world have kind of got in touch with us around the Bondi Hipsters thing. And we're kind of, for the meanwhile, we're still just going to focus on the internet and growing an audience online. Mm. And we've still got more musical numbers that we want to put up and some more songs and stuff like that. But
more goji berries.
A few more goji berries to eat and a few more, you know, a few more bad retail jokes to be made.
But do you hate hipsters? Is that the deal?
Look, I lived in Bondi for about 3 or 4 years and I kind of watched the transition of Bondi kind of getting infiltrated and overtaken by the hipsters, but I by no means hate hipsters. I think they're beautiful creatures.
And Bondi is just so hip. Is there anywhere in Sydney that comes close, or is it just the hippest place in the world?
Look, right. Newtown's getting there,
a bit
I reckon.
Hip.
Surrey Hills is getting there.
Oh, really?
All right, we've got to go. We've got to get out on our fixies and go home.
Okay. You need some non-prescription glasses.
All right.